Let's as always start with the current progress of SpaceX's Starship at Boca Chica. What is the plan with SN5 and 6 for this week? Now, on the topic of SpaceX, we of course must also talk about the SpaceX and ULA launch contracts for the US military. Oh, and this is going to be good. Elon also had some strong opinions on that, as do we.
Then Rogozin is at it again, delivering some highly entertaining remarks. Also very entertaining is what NASA sometimes does. For example, renaming some offensive space objects to fully comply with the current PC Magnus zeitgeist. But NASA is also making giant progress on Artemis. They installed an adapter. Oh, and we also have some news on Doug Loverro, SpaceX's latest funding round, and the speed of Starlink. This episode will be quite rank heavy. So if you love political correctness, please turn off now. Everyone else, stay tuned.
Times are exciting, and especially at Boca Chica, where every day so much is happening. For example, Elon posted an awesome picture of SN5 and SN6 side by side. The old prototype that already hopped, and the new one that will hop. The old 301-based stainless steel alloy versus the new 304L-based one. SpaceX now has two functioning prototypes that can hop, and the third one with SN8 under development, which, as we said, will be the first one to be fully assembled, complete with nose cone and flaps for the 20-kilometer hop test later this year. SN5 is now together with SN8 in the high bay, or wait, is it now the mid bay, now that the super heavy high bay is the highest bay? Apparently the consensus is mid bay, so we'll totally go along with that term. SN8 will soon be fully stacked, while SN5 undergoes maintenance to prepare it for the next hops. Thanks as always to Mary aka Boca Chica Gal and NASA Spaceflight for these amazing shots. Please go out and check out their awesome channel. SN6 will be the next prototype to undergo major tests, and for that purpose, it has been carried and placed onto the launch mount.
The spaceflight activity beach closure request reveals the schedule for the upcoming cryo proof tests. The primary closure date was yesterday on Sunday, August 16th, with backup closure dates today and tomorrow. We know that the cryo pressure test always comes first, to test the maximum tank pressure at cryogenic temperatures. Since the 304L-based steel has better material properties at cryogenic temperatures, Starship SN6 should perform better than SN5. After the cryo tests, we will have the green runs, static fire, and then hopefully soon, maybe already next week, we can see the next Starship hop with SN6. By that time, SN5 might be ready again, so we might see Starship hops quite frequently from now on. Meanwhile, the Super Heavy high bay is getting taller and taller. And the launch pad for Super Heavy is also progressing, with more rebar pillars being cast into the ground. SpaceX now even has robots that are being tested to install the hexagonal heat shield tiles on Starship. As for the future of Boca Chica, a new job posting calls for a resort development manager. While we don't have very specific information yet on how exactly this will look, the idea of a 21st century spaceport resort is really cool. This will be basically like Mos Eisley's spaceport, but at the coast, not in the desert, and minus the scum and villainy.
But now to a topic that makes us really angry, so angry in fact that we can barely keep the She-Hulk at bay. See what I mean? But before we get to that topic, please consider to subscribe to the most aggressive and non-PC space and technology channel on YouTube. Because not only does this help us tremendously, but you will also be able to vote on the topics for our Friday videos. And you'll also of course have our utmost gratitude. And it's completely free. So, the ULA and SpaceX satellite launch contract for the US military. First and foremost, the US Space Force, the National Reconnaissance Office, and the Missile Defense Agency. This launch contract is worth billions of dollars and foresees many satellite launches in a 5-year window from 2022 until 2027. Now, many news outlets reported this as a big win for SpaceX, as they got 40% of those so-called Phase 2 missions, beating Blue Origin and Northrop Grumman. But who got the major share? That's right, good old ULA. What news media outlets were praising as a big win for SpaceX is actually a blatant display of taxpayer money waste and a confirmation that lobbying, which is just a euphemism for corruption, does indeed pay off. Of course, Tory Bruno, president and CEO of ULA, shows himself positively surprised, saying, "We knew we were going to be competitive." Yeah, we bet being competitive sure works best when you have good lobbyists in Congress, right? Elon also had some strong opinions regarding the contract.
He tweeted that this is a substantial underpayment compared to what the ULA has received. And also that, since the ULA is relying on non-reusable, completely expendable rockets, this is like buying airplanes that fly only once, which then crash into the ocean after use. And no, the Vulcan rocket doesn't count, as only its engines are reusable, which is a complete joke. Sorry. It's like throwing away the whole airplane, but only keeping the turbines. The ULA is, by the way, a joint venture of Boeing and Lockheed. So why is this madness acceptable for ULA rockets? Lastly, Elon said that over time, it will become obvious that ULA is a complete waste of taxpayer money. Well, we already said it often, and we will say it again. Lobbyism.
Lobbyism. Corruption. That's why.
While for people like you and us here in the space community, this has already been obvious for many years. We really hope that more YouTube channels will start talking openly and more aggressively about lobbying and corruption regarding Boeing and Lockheed. We really have to speak openly about such stuff. So, celebrate the launch contracts for SpaceX? Yes, but only when the ULA is where they should be, namely together with the other companies that rely on non-reusable rockets, on the graveyard of disrupted companies. And the engineers working at ULA might do a lot more good for humanity working for SpaceX.
Oh, and now a topic that we really love. NASA has decided to go full PC compliant by removing some, as they say, offensive names from deep sky objects. Eskimo Nebula? Offensive? PC violation detected? Does not comply with current zeitgeist? Will henceforward be known as NGC 2392. Siamese Twins Galaxy? Offensive. Must be eliminated from speech. Henceforward shall be known as NGC 4567 and 4568. Thanks, NASA. Thanks. We are very sure this will help to end racism once and for all. And we will enter a new golden age where racism will be a thing of the past, thanks to NASA. You know our stance on PC. We think it's just another form of censorship. Censorship in the guise of friendliness and manners.
This obsession with semantics, as if renaming words, making them sound friendlier, also makes reality friendlier. Hint? It doesn't. In other news, NASA's former chief of human spaceflight, Doug Loverro, might face criminal investigation for secretly helping Boeing with the Human Landing Systems Award in NASA's Artemis Moon program. We really hope it won't come to that, because despite all, we liked Loverro. Under his supervision, SpaceX got the Lunar Gateway resupply missions with Dragon XL and Falcon Heavy, and was even awarded a chunk for the moon version of Starship. So he really did a lot for SpaceX. But on Boeing, Loverro had us completely fooled. So let's see how this will develop when the results of the current investigation from NASA's Inspector General are released.
One more news on SpaceX. It seems that the sum of the latest funding round now has been increased to $2 billion. They are close to finalizing this latest funding round, which would bring in $2 billion of new investment money. SpaceX is currently valued at $44 billion. This is excellent as we are sure that a lot of this new capital will flow directly into development of Starship. Regarding Starlink, we now have the first data from the internal beta test. Users report 11 to 60 megabit per second download and 5 to 18 megabits per second upload speeds. These are of course not yet final numbers and will improve. Some users got latencies as low as 20 milliseconds, which is really excellent. Starlink will go online for North American customers in early 2021. Excellent news for all people living in rural areas. Now some funny news. Our friend Dimitri Rogozin is in his element again, saying some really entertaining stuff, which makes even the Hulk laugh. Rogozin, chief of Roscosmos, knows that the Russian Space Agency is basically dying. As if an annual budget of $2.4 billion wasn't small enough, this budget will be cut even more in the coming years by as much as 10%. So what do we do faced with such brutal circumstances? That's right, bark as loud as possible. Classic. Rogozin said that not only will Russia develop reusable rockets, which are going to surpass SpaceX, yes, really, he said that, surpass SpaceX, but no, they will also return to Venus, which according to Rogozin is a much better target than Mars anyways and has always been a Russian planet. And of course, he also said a few weeks ago that Roscosmos is planning to build a moon base together with China. He really can talk, this guy. He really can talk. But we highly doubt that we'll see even one of his announcements come true.
And what is NASA doing meanwhile on Artemis? Huge progress? Yes. If you call installing the Orion adapter for Artemis 1, huge progress. Then yes. So this adapter connects the Orion capsule to the upper stage of SLS. By the way, Artemis 1 is the unmanned mission which will take the Orion capsule around the moon in late 2021. Yes, late 2021. Progress on Artemis is really painfully slow, and Congress bills like the HR 5666, about which we talked in this video here, might delay Artemis even more. We really hope this bill will never pass the Senate. And you can, by the way, also help by writing to your representatives. What a massive pile of garbage this bill is. Okay, you might want to use a bit more euphemistic language, but you get the idea. We hope NASA can really speed up this Artemis, else we can completely forget the 2024 moon landing. Well, at least NASA ended racism once and for all by renaming those deep sky objects.
And if you want to know if China could actually copy Starship and build their own starships, you can watch this video here.
So thanks for watching the JI Space Report, and I would say, on to the future! Oh!